toward the other way?
Not this way?
Not that way.
No, that's as far as I can go right there.
Okay.
Get the cowl.
Just need it to go, need my bottom end to go that way, like half an inch.
Well, that went way easier than we thought it would.
Easy?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I guess that's what you call easy, sitting in a parking lot for 2.5 hours, trying to go through the bottom, through the top, through the bottom, listening to some choice words from him.
Yeah, I cut my hands up. They're a smidgen dirty.
Watching YouTube. Getting back out.
Yeah, I watched YouTube just like, all right, how does it go to the top to the bottom? We couldn't figure out which way it was supposed to fish through because it wouldn't fit in there at all. And oh, yeah, every video, we always, you just gotta, it squeezes in there, snake it in there, this, that, blah, yeah, BS.
Everyone said top to bottom. Well,
we almost
did bottom to top. We went bottom to top.
Yeah, we couldn't even get it remotely close fishing that thing through the top. I don't know what them guys are smoking or what they did, but ours didn't fit like that. Not at all. We couldn't even get it halfway down and through there, and you had to twist it, but the only problem was is the windshield and the hood was in the way.
But we got it.
We're
hooked back up.
Yeah, we're hooked back up. Now we're sitting at the parking lot at the 605 again. Trying to debate. Yeah, you can see that flag over there.
Yeah.
Winds are blowing, well, it depends on which weather app you look at, anywhere from 20 to 35 mile an hour, gusting to 40, 45, and the interstate's right there. There's an overpass. We have seen quite a few campers go by.
Couple multi-haul.
Yeah, a couple multi-haul guys, and just from where we're sitting, you can see the campers leaning and swaying from where we're at.
You can, yep.
So we're debating on what to do. The winds are not supposed to die down until, what was it, like 8 o'clock tomorrow night? Something like that? 6 o'clock tomorrow night?
Well, it's supposed to die down for a little bit here and there.
Yeah, it's supposed to die down for about 4 hours tonight, but still it's dying down to 20.
Which I think it is slowly starting to die down here.
It seems gusty. The flag calms down a lot, but then all of a sudden it takes off again.
Yeah.
And then it kind of calms down again, but just sitting here. We're rocking just sitting here.
Yeah.
I mean, we probably would be all right, but the way our week's gone so far, I really don't want to go topsy-turvy. So, yeah. And then we went over to the Clark over there because they got the fuel over there. There's no discounts, but their fuel over there was, what, 5 cents cheaper than, or I don't know. What was my cheapest? I don't remember what it was, but anyway.
It was like $4.49 over there.
Yeah, it's $4.49 over there, but it was cheaper than any of the... My three fuel apps, well, two fuel apps and my EFS card, they were the cheapest. So we went over there, and that was a joke. It took us forever to get filled up. Pump kicks off at 75 on my EFS card. So then, or no, it was my Shields card I used. Kicks off at $75, which got me 16 gallons. I'm like, we're not playing this game. So then I tried my EFS card, and then it kicked off at 150. So then I had to swipe the card for the third time to try and top off. And I was watching the pump and whatever, and I was thinking it's got to be full by now, you know. But it did lean, so I figured it was going to get more in the tank than normal. I just happened to look out my passenger side window, and I seen diesel fuel running off the bed of my truck. Well, the pump didn't click off. So.
And then.
That was probably my bad, too.
So he gets out. Leaves his door open because he's trying to shut the pump off quick. So then I open my door to get out and see if he needs any help. You know, I don't know what I'm going to do with fuel spilling down the side of the truck, catch it, or I don't know. Anyway, I open my door and it's crazy windy. So one of our fuel receipts blows out the window. So I start
chasing. Up the bank by the interstate.
Yeah, I start chasing it down the parking lot. Goes over the fence. So then we, had to go chase it. Up the
embankment for the overpass.
Yeah.
So we got it.
That was a good time. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people should really quit littering. There's a lot of garbage there.
There's a lot of butt wipes in the ditch.
Yeah, there is.
I'm not sure what that's all about.
Yeah. So that was the most excitement we had today, though, is chasing a fuel receipt. Yeah. Oh, no, it's not. We played pool again at the 6:05.
Oh, yeah, we played 2 games of pool. I whooped her butt twice, but the first game I scratched on the 8-ball once again.
So I win.
Second time, though, I didn't.
No, he didn't.
And then, actually...
And I was doing so good that first game, too. I was down to the 8-ball, and he still had, like, 3 balls on the table, and still came back and hit them all in before me.
And then we sat down at the bar, and we didn't have any alcoholic drinks. We just had a couple of pops, sodas, depending where you're from.
Diet Coke. Whoop, whoop.
Diet Cola. I ran into an old friend. I haven't seen him in about 2-3 years. All of a sudden, we walk in the bar, and I just happened to look over, and I was like, no way. Which he lives about 60 miles from here, so it's just kind of different. I was like, it's kind of a small little town, little bar like this, and only 2 people in the bar, and it just so happens to be somebody you know.
We found out we're the talk of the town.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We decided after a while, we went over to the Clark and got some chips and cheeseburgers from over there. And I was talking to the guy behind the counter for a while. He's asking where we were from and whatever. And told him that we were kind of broke down, but I had the truck kind of fixed until our part comes in and whatnot. And he goes, oh, you got the campers over there. Well, here, apparently, every other person that comes into that gas station, we're the talk of the town because we're broke down and hitting up all the different stores here in town just checking stuff out. So when you come into a small town that's got about 300 people, apparently when someone else is in town for 2 days, that's quite the hit.
And when he means we were checking out the stores in town, he meant the restaurant, the gas station, and the hotel. Mm-hmm. Because that's all that's in town other than an elevator. So we did check every single one of them out other than the elevator.
We didn't check out the grocery store.
Oh, yeah, they have a grocery store.
There is a grocery store here.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's probably enough jabbering for now, but we're just trying to figure out whether we want to get on the road and buck the wind or what we're going to do. Like I said, the weather doesn't really show the wind calming down and getting under 15 mile an hour until about 8 o'clock tomorrow night. So now we got to figure out what we're going to do.
We're really hoping to be home tomorrow night. But we'll see.
Yeah, we're still going to try. But yeah, we're racking a lot just sitting here. So fuel mileage is not going to work out for us either. Mm-mm. Alright, we'll catch up with you guys later. We decided last night we were going to just run a little ways, see how the wind did, and I think we made it, what, about an hour? Wasn't horrible. Fuel mileage was crap. And then the wing, like, almost completely died, so we just kept running. We were going to try and make it to Billings last night, but it was, what, was it 2 in the morning? It was, like, 2 in the morning here, so 3 o'clock for our local time and central time, and we were both getting tired. She had already passed out the passenger seat. She was bobbling her head, so... We hit up the rest area here in Sheridan, Wyoming. It was dark last night, so she's never been up this way, so she's never seen the big horns or nothing like that.
Very pretty.
So, at least today she'll get to see all that. We'll drop off in Billings, and then we'll see if we get any cars. The cars I planned on getting are obviously gone. And we just checked out Central, and there is one car on our whole route. And that goes from Billings to Billings, so...
13 miles. I mean, the good news is it pays well. It's like 1307 a mile, but you know.
Yeah.
As of right now, we probably won't have a backhaul. We're going to try and make it back to Mitchell. Maybe do some graduation present shopping at the Cabela's. We'll see. Otherwise, no problems with the truck last night. The wind completely died, so it was actually a really nice drive. The mule deer were kind of out heavy. We've seen a couple of them splattered all over the road, and then we saw, two or one?
I think we saw a few.
I think we saw a couple. They were staying right on the shoulder. And then there was one road sign that played tricks with me. It was actually the road sign, the light off. The reflection of the road sign was reflecting off the road, and it was like a gray color, so I randomly hit the brakes thinking there was a deer standing right in the right lane, and it was just reflection messing with me. But yeah, so there's that was what we woke up to this morning. They had quite a bit of snow out here yesterday. Yesterday morning. It was more ice, I guess, but we didn't run into any of that last night. So it was a really nice drive. There's like no wind today. A little breeze. Somebody's burning something over that way.
It's a beautiful day here.
The smoke ain't really moving from whatever they're burning. We got about 45 minutes left before our 10 hours is up. And then we got, hour and a half drive to Billings. Something like that. 145 minutes. So I was kind of hoping for a really nice stiff west wind today, but get some nice fuel mileage on the way home. But, it never works in your favor that way. At least for me. Whatever direction the wind's blowing, that's the direction I'm going into. My mom even calls and checks on me sometimes. She goes, "You must be heading south," or whatever direction. It's like, yep. And then the Conoco over there played tricks on us. We thought it'd be really handy to walk over there and grab some coffee, but it's under construction. The guys came out and started telling us how they felt bad, and they're gonna give us a ride somewhere. And it's like, no, don't worry about it.
Yeah. Like, we walked like...
Yeah, it's literally right there. We're like, well, down the hill and across, and he was gonna give us either a ride back to the rest area or a ride to go get coffee. He's like, no, well, we'll grab some coffee somewhere else. Not a big deal.
Next time.
All right. Well, here in a little bit, we'll hit the road, and then we got to hit a pilot. We are at a close. We look like a bunch of grody bums. So we either got to go buy some clothes somewhere or do some laundry at a pilot. We need showers, too.
We showered yesterday, to be fair, so before we left the hotel.
But we were crawling on the ground. I got sand, and then I even got tar stuck in my hair.
Yes, he did.
Not that I got a lot of hair to get tar stuck in, and somehow I got tar stuck in my hair. So she thought it was fun to rip that out.
When he told his parents that, his dad's comment was, "Were you doing it with your shirt off?" Good one, Jim.
Family's got jokes. Everybody's got to pick on the bald guy.
I love your baldness, honey.
All right. We're probably going to go mosey around for a little bit, kill some time, and we'll see you on the road. It'd be nice if they unloaded the campers that way. We wouldn't have to roll them off or nothing.
Although it does seem to be quite a long process, so I think our way was quicker.
Yeah, we're already unloaded.
22 minutes.
We're already unloaded. He's doing the check-in right now. I just haven't heard beeping noises and looked over and seen that big crane in the air, and I'm like, they're not unloading the boats that way, are they? And sure enough, they are.
Look at them go.
You think they would have their own hoist here, but
it could be.
I doubt they own that. Unless they look at up at the lakes, they got those A-frames with electric winches. The truck just drives underneath of it. They pick them up, the truck drives out, they drop it, backs back in, unload.
Yeah.
That's quite the process here, though. That's probably quite the crane bill, I would assume. I don't know. Because that truck was parked over on the other side of those campers there. That crane. It was running and there was a guy sitting in it. I just didn't think that was for here for boats. I don't know. right, well, I guess if you want to know how a boat was unloaded. Let's fast forward a little bit. We made it home from Billings. We took a back, the back roads, was it 212, I think it's 212. So we took kind of the two-lane highway on the way back just to kind of check out some different scenery. And man, we saw a lot of deer and a lot of antelope. There was a lot of antelope. I've never seen that many in one trip. So that was kind of cool, kind of seeing a little bit different. I've seen there's a lot of transporters on that road, so a lot of you guys must take that route instead of taking 90 all the way across and then up. It does cut off a little bit of time by taking that highway. But so we've been kind of talking a little bit about doing some different things, and we've been talking about it for probably 2-3 months now. It just, the price of everything right now, it just didn't seem right, but we had something kind of come up as opportunity, so we're gonna go check that out here in a little bit. Not gonna tell you exactly what it is right now, kind of leave it as a little teaser. But it is, what is today? It's Monday now already, so we haven't done any filming the last few days and just been really busy. I've been getting campers out of storage. We have a few campers that we store for people, so that's actually what I got behind me right now is a fifth wheel that we stored for a couple and gonna go drop it off at their house. And then after that, we're going to go check out that other thing. Yeah, we've had a lot of people pulling campers out of storage. Spring's coming. Everybody's getting spring fever and getting their campers cleared out. The ones that are picking up now are, they got permanent sites or their hosts or something like that at campgrounds that they kind of get a little jump start on everything. But everything went good with the truck after we changed the intercooler tube out. I haven't had any problems. Everything's running awesome. I can actually tell, I probably should have put that tube on when I did the other side. When I did the turbo, there was actually a noticeable difference in power and a noticeable difference in fuel mileage. So kind of taking it easier on it. I don't want too much power and start ripping stuff apart in the truck. So, but having a factory intercooler tube and then going to an aftermarket that's 3-inch, it's definitely getting a lot more air to the engine. So that's a bonus. I think we gained on average, I think we averaged about 1 mile per gallon more now that we got the whole system in it. But yeah, like I said, we've just been really busy. The wife's honey-do list is always a good time. She decided that we're ripping the floors out and putting new flooring in, which our carpet we've talked about since we moved into that house, that it needs a lot of updating. We've done a lot of painting and a lot of stuff like that on the walls, but it needs new windows and trim and flooring and new cupboards and stuff like that. Just nothing's really wrong with anything. It's just old, outdated stuff is kind of worn. But so we're doing new flooring. She wanted all that stuff done before graduation, so we spent 2 days doing flooring. We're almost done. We got half the living room left and flooring's all done, and then we'll have to start working on trim work and whatever. But it's kind of the wrong time of the year to be doing that, because this is, it's getting a little busy with camper reservations, plus still hauling campers and all that fun stuff. But my original plan was to head out today to go grab another load. But yeah, with people wanting all their campers out of storage and whatnot, I decided to stay home today and help do that. And now looking at the weather, they're talking some ice and stuff in the next 2 days, so I might not even be heading out the next 2 days. So probably just finish up work on the house and get that stuff done while I'm home. And yeah, but so we're gonna go drop this off,
and then we'll be back here in a little bit, and I'll kind of give you a little teaser on what we might be doing here coming up shortly. So yeah, we'll show you that. Otherwise, we'll see you in the next one.